Well, hello and welcome to a particularly special edition of the MLP vlog. It's special for, well, two reasons. And one is that we'll be covering a movie this time, you know, which I've done before, King Rapids. It's special that I'm doing this at 5 a.m. I've done this a little late before, but I believe the late I did with Gavin Rocco and Al Goyle, which got me 5. And hung at 5 a.m. there'll be two things in mind. One, I'm one guy who don't get premature, hope I get tired, go kick a.m. big one with me. But if I got you wake a lot of new, which is fine. You know, that's and the other thing is that means everyone out complete, which means I have to be a bit quiet. That's why I couldn't do it in my room, and I didn't want to long be laptop all the way over here when I could just use my mom's computer. I'm gonna be uploading it for a computer, so and thankfully my dad can tend to get up to and go. The thing we're talking about today is Crunchyroll, My Little Pony, Crunchyroll 4, Legend of the Everfree, written by John Lewis and Christian Franco, and it being Netflix, the Crunchyroll movie getting Netflix was here before the Scary Family. It gets him gotten from the first two movies being released, minor theatrical release before being bought through TV, and then to Netflix and DVD, or whatever. Different movies of being on TV for, they get to me back on Netflix. We don't know TV, we don't know. It aren't pretty new, but some people were chopped off, which I think all the people caught early. You can get it to one. Go, there you go. And so what came on, and I'm still planning what to do it tomorrow, but I have so much work to do that, in hindsight, yeah, I could have waited until all my work and done this guy, like, 10 or so, to buy I told I got to work on live action, they count me for the blog, I got to do the MLP episode of the vlog, I got to work on most of the preview, I got the marathon, the TV stuff I watch, you know. Well, and of course, the Digicom Halloween episode already started, well, just right now, the MLP allowed me for quite a while, so in order to type room view, because the year I'm doing with your name Halloween stuff, you know, whatever. So I mean, so by that point it'd be like 10 or 11 or so. Go, I'll be that late, you know, like, cause most people probably don't wait until like the day, like, I'll be ton late. But then I kind of do it in the time between when we leave after midnight and, well, today. And I've had to go out to do it, but I just got lazy. I already put a video right about to start watching it, so thank you for hindering it. I love it when they have a video interview where you like put out a good interview, but I have to watch the video right away. Then I've gone like in kind of like, you know, bottom part of the coming up, I can wait. Already right away. You know, that's a good. So I give credit to him. Anyway, I'm gonna try and make it quick. But yeah, I still gotta go into some detail, and hell, most of the people who feed me early, I'm gonna do watch on before any of them can. So, anyway, quick video for, like, the post recent. I forgot to bring up new DVD guests for free. I've showed off enough in the last video, but oh well. Anyway, but now gave a pencil. Anyway, so to recap, the first one, the second one, very good. Third one, pretty good. So, and we've had an interesting relationship movie. Again, they keep coming out each year. They come out. If I'm calling the. Actually, I gotta pop here. Okay. And I'm back. Wow. I should probably need to pop up more often. People interrupt me. And I'm back again. Okay. Where was I? Okay. Each time we cover our campaign, right? I do find it interesting to play the campaign. First one being intriguing, but now this one, pretty one where during the campaign, you know, hell, you know, so. You know, and chronological placement, who knows. Each one, they took play chronically, but for a printed game, took play Meraki and Akita D-Mark, because they're going to be on that. Summer camp point, who may get around back. Summer already corrupts the other time. Although, it's going to be in October, because they're going to put yellow to the point. I guess you have to make them in October. Anyway, but on to the movie. I'm not going to compare it to the Everfree much, but I kind of have to, because when it comes to franchise, you can do, especially in franchise, take elements from the Everfree. Each one kind of a distinctive theme to it, I don't know, including the contract and just the plot. First movie, generalized for but very dance related. The Pokemon one battle land, Ruby a Marching Band, school fight court, and Zig in camp. Well, that's kind of an accident. So in this movie, the Christian gang, Christian girl gang are off to Camp Everfree, you know. And Twilight is a bit worried because after what happened at Sparkle movie, she worried that stuff makes it. And some magic stuff starting to happen all over the place, thinking that someone is thinking behind it. And once they hear the someone's legend about this guy at Everfree Burger, they think some very interesting might be afoot at the camp. So, I've watched a few of so many things, but I'm gonna try to keep them cool. I'm gonna talk about two things first. First, the animation. That game, mechanically really stepped up for me, but first again, this one, the character animation is a lot, probably the best. The character animation is really good, it's very much more fluid, and current characters work better, but a lot of them just move more fluidly, they don't speak our language. Fluidly. But the thing is, there aren't quite any flash modes. Again, we got a lot of flash modes, like the climax, or that one of the new toys don't get at night. You know, this movie didn't have many fighters. There are some fighters more keener, but not quite as many. Which is fine, I feel like we're not trying to. Because the budget really needs to get slightly smaller, because the first two were having pressure on them, because we don't have much pressure on them. We're getting to the point where we have to get 10 to throw away, which was my biggest worry going into this one, but I'll get into that in the end. And another thing is the soundtrack, which is probably the weakest one against the first. They stand out a bit more in the first movie, but most of the time, like one song stands out one way or the other. And that would be the villain song, which is arguable Arkham. Yeah, again, we villain song at the point getting, we know, of all the different kind of wearing a glare on the forehead, that making me look balder than I really am. I can't, like, already kind of get into the think of it. I get it from my back, but that's what I mean. That's what it is, not that. Yeah, but those ones are pretty cool, especially, you know, but they're fun for night, and they obviously a campfire song type feel, but even the opening sequence itself doesn't stick out much, because the visual agent of camp going through stuff and human name riveting, you know. Kind of the other movies where they really had the cool graphic of the character and all the cool stuff, and really got pumped up for the movie. Even the first one here, it's a cute opening sequence. And all songs are just nice compared to the like, one song turns out to be awesome, the rest of them are nice. Some of them I can't look right, but honestly, I have the one song, the contract got released on iTunes a week ago, and someone put it on YouTube, and I didn't want to spoil it too much, so I just looked into a song that kind of evoked like a long song. And yeah, it turned out that it evoked. But I was looking to come a lyric, I'm like, it's like a cowl. I'll get to it in a minute. But there you go. Animation, about the same, well, the character animation is probably the best so far. And the contract is not bad, but it's better for me because it can stick out a little more because of more comic con queen. You know, but, you know. And the songs, they do kind of play with gaming. In fact, for me, I don't know, this one is kind of gaming. And again, one song is more to a comic family. Basically, we have another song that's like games about stuff. And now for the plot. One of my big points going to this one is that this would be the filler entry, but one that each of them one has put a purpose narratively. The three issues for the conga, the tech one took against him and tried to develop a lot further and give her a place in the group. You know, in the first movie, one two issues to hit with Twilight and all of her stuff. And the fourth movie would be the filler one where yeah, I would just want them to do a TV show, because that's what they start off as. Like, the first one clearly is a pilot for a TV series. I think the company kind of, like, admitted they didn't really have any idea for what to do with that first movie. Well, can't you make King coming like Project Rock, you know you're gonna make people that money. But, they probably plan to do a spin-off show after that, but, like, I just did a movie. And this doesn't really feel like coming up, probably being finished on a TV show episode, you know? You know, and again, I won't get after that. I like it before. But unfortunately, it got some problems. There's one element that really makes me like the. There's one element that does better in the Friendship game, but the rest of it is gear on par slightly weaker. First of all, each of the movies can kind of theme in that. The only two characters, well, main characters, back at any point in the element, try it again. The first movie, I get the other character hacked for me, but only because we had this one. Yeah, first movie, try it again. I can't get the end twice to move to it. Second movie, it's twice. I can't get rid of it. Well, we are into a slight development, but the first movie, there's none of that for them, and it's fine. Okay. Well, for this version of Twilight, I can kind of forgive that. Literally, it gets rid of Twilight. Okay. Oh, the other characters are kind of there for the ride. Okay. Well, this one left me, I think, slightly if I have an extra character again. Have one of my characters get minor things compared to the other movie, which didn't do as much. And by having an extra character get development at the moment. And speaking of character, I'll give that for a few minutes. Making the big emotional thing going on with the biggest conflict in terms of emotional. I'm talking about big internal conflict in terms of character development. It was Twilight Zone Ribbon, I think. Which we kinda did before in Rainbow Rock when Sunset dealing with the fact that she was the one that she doesn't want to, touch and blah, 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 blah. You remember that running joke where they would actually, bring up that she was only going to cry, she could know that, and then for me, they do it again. Not to the extent of me, but one probably has a few, but one that does take a mind is that they kind of, we get she was a villain. They dropped that early on, but for early on at all. That can't say it. Early on, it only broke up a couple. At the point where I'm like, okay, we get it, before that went on, so that's fine. And that kind of a big problem with the movie is that it doesn't borrow a lot from the movie more, and it doesn't, the emotional stuff they do is still new enough to be engaging and even be slightly better, probably. Okay, this one's better, first movie. Because we'll stuff. I'm not giving motion for free, which, that kind of thing. And to be fair, don't make it do for income. It's nice enough, but by the end of the movie, she's a big character that she doesn't want to use magic because she's afraid midnight come out. By the end of the movie, she knows that, as long as she's to help her, she won't do that. And that's one of the big things in the movie is that magic can be good. And that kind of big thing in front of a lot of people, that magic is what you make of it. There's a lot of work that they can say that, you can magic, and if you aren't, you get gonna do. I mean, the Haunting Hour had a go-con looking for now, but big feedback. Boom, you're from that evil, and then it's the main character that can get to kill people. And the hearing, have been kind of funny, because one, that main character have the element of magic. But it feels like every time a character, even her, kind of use magic, the kind of magic that they, aka magic, you bet it doesn't come from them, you're gonna paint my face for that, then, that thing can kind of happen, But it seems like I think a lot of they do teach that, hey, just because we're having all magic, that'd be natural bad. If you have a team in Heal World, you can kind of teach that with a bit more directly, I kind of like that, but on the other hand, I'm gonna spoil this, I'm gonna try not to spoil a ton, but there's only one element, there are two elements you might find be unexpected. They are out. Kind of club, you can't attend much, but I remember seeing a single trailer until a day or so before. Now, I've heard the game guy read to find out much later, but this one, I didn't really know a whole lot going to it. I didn't even know Midnight was gonna be a part of an archetype of a song title of Midnight and me. It could be a longer one, but. Well, I hope this thing again. I don't know what limit my laptop webcam had, but go up to 40 minutes, I know that. And fine, it's not gonna current point, I'll start over and I'll skip a lot of it. But the thing is, by the end of the movie, the humane, they have permanent out of pound the plot device thing I won't get into, because they have magic pound prints permanent. And it came from Commodore Prime being confidential, although it can apply to a leaf in the country, and I'm not trying to feel like that, because one of the whole point of the franchise that they're human, then they don't have magic power to begin with, and they just get a little help from it. The only magic power got put in crucial moments, very, And it was just done, you know, that's the people that kind of vegan, yeah, to ability. But here, now I have that permanently, it feels like they're no different we are in the show, because they are, you know, for the most part, they are required to have talent to help them out. Like, you know, very, very, especially they have, like, you know, flying and the, right? But, you know, here that makes no difference. And to be fair, not in the first movie, there's not much that makes them different compared to their human, but I can imagine making you too much like it. That's not a big problem here, because who knows, maybe down the road they'll just say, oh, well, if you get for help, and it'll, you know, won't be a quite big deal, you know. And can for really being the only big, like, tack, like, when they have to, you know, create game, work of the show, but they just do it for everything. But I do think the way it works narrowly can make up for that, but I do feel like it. Usually I'm not putting a point out the thing, that's the kind of nitpicky thing we had. Don't really point out, but here I am pointing it out. I guess before I move on to good Sarah thing, I keep lying, I gotta talk about bad thing. So at this point, let's talk about Flag Entry, he ends up going a little more than the other. So the first movie, he won the part, but they act like his part, but like I can't, he done so much for her, like he is a love interest. But in one thing he helped her out, but I'm gonna that Stacy David giggle at each other a lot. Narratively, he doesn't really care much about her, but he doesn't give control to my a whole lot. Speaking of controlling, remember that gag in Fetch It Games where a Derby show control Flash? Our turn here. I ship it. Second and third movie. Second one, he was controlled by the dangling and became a little too twined. So he had a little bit more peripheral there, but in general, his role kind of reduced go a bit better. For me, he hinted for a couple of things, and now he did kind of more improvement. If he did, then I go for, if I thought I forgot improvement, then the fact that I forgot told you all you need to know about more improvement for the movie. The movie, he also doesn't take the first improvement, but he don't get more of a, first of all, remember the fact that he didn't look at it? Can you too, because we mentioned it, bring up a couple times for the movie, then never again. Even though she becomes a big character, you think they would bring up the fact that they dated one, so, you know, that would give them a weird feeling. Here, they bring it up again, and they give them a point, oh, but that could imply certain thing, but one problem is that they don't follow up on that. She does finally get over 20% because he, in kind of awkward, this world tried, becomes fat people were over tried, and okay, they told him, go try, next you can pay him over tried, thank you. Outside of that, they, and one, you know, by the end of the movie, they get the habit, but after that scene, where he kind of looks like, she doesn't really do anything major again for the movie, which makes me think there must have been some deleted, like, scenes or art or something like that. So, especially the game, Vera Horror couldn't get the kind where she wanted to go out to Equestria or not. And that one big thing I kind of wondered, because it's like, okay, are we going to address that she was from Equestria at one point, and how she feels about things here? What do you find that? Or what the whole condition, or the hatching of the condition, because this stuff that we know here came from a question to begin with. And that's what they bring up in this movie, but they don't. So, I guess that'll be a plot of this movie. Virga, probably you can call a sleeping bag. Oh, while on subject, they have their credit there, the full credit team. It's not a cranky one with Maroc, it's just a more of a cute gang kind of thing. Just gang rides, can you think of some crazy here, but before that, they're going to claim something called a people bag, something, if they don't reject it, then it's not that big a deal, but they're going to tell me that will be a big enough part that they might address that in the next movie. They keep losing it yearly, but next year will be a legitimate movie of fear, so they might, that might clash, so they might not do one next year. If they do, it's going to be, like, far away, so it can't be around this time. And I am back. Okay, where was I? Oh yeah, congratulations, bleed stuff and finish the game. Yeah, she would have a horn where she followed going home and she only got not to. They had the ring for cutting it, I can't remember, but when I heard it, I went, okay, that makes sense. The ending scene is actually better. I like it more than anything in the ending movie because I feel like having directing that made it all right nice. But again, narrowly I can see why they didn't need that. But if you want to hear, comedy right there with commentary explaining why. And by the teen tongue, I believe some stuff I'm complaining about because they clearly they had to be stuff cut or something they wanted to put in, but they couldn't. And I'm gonna be contrary on DVD officially, it's been confirmed, so I'm gonna get you. Or, cause I have all the other movies, I can have the first movie to a weekend. I ain't got to figure it. You probably we have my mortgage. We couldn't, you know, find it. Click on it. You know, whatever. And now, turning on my well and getting like a yoke affair, if God or if it's bad writing. Covering comes down a few years from that. Anyway, go, wild child, go. Ring I brought out a big ring about for Shyam. Like that. Trying to get from my queen figure character who is the assistant to the chick who run Cap Everfree. And at first, they think there might be a love triangle, which I hate love triangles. I mean, bad enough from Powerpuff Girls, you know, but they don't go that route. But they do catch a way where it feels like bad writing more than trying to cover it. Because we bring it up, they seem quite like him, but they never bring it up again. Again, if they're an intentional triangle, they have a character, hey, let's not do a love triangle thing, whatever. Then, nope, they just kind of forget about it. In the end, point to like, kind of point up with him. Not officially, but they have a moment. I imagine the community of like, and some people might think twice. I think twice that could work now, because the community probably would be wrong, but nothing weird that. I don't know why you need to get over Twilight when this Twilight is totally dateable, you know? Yeah. They teach me a certain thing, but never officially happened. I feel like if that's near the end, if Dev in the middle, like it doesn't get one of the feel a lot better, but coming in the middle, it feels like incomplete. Because in the end, Flash is kind of no one kept going. You then try and end up with this new character. To be fair, I like the new character, he's tying into something. Thing, and he's genuinely kind of charming, you know, going at me together, it's nice enough, you know, compared to answering the first movie, but I just kind of fumble around a lot, you know. So, I bet a couple people will find him charming enough to move for them, or just go, no, she should be come wrong. Some people for try, don't get, including me. Oh, God, come on, that's like, for me, I believe that. But, you know, because we're human, they had to adhere more to the hetero agenda. I'm tumbling now. Oh boy, but yeah, there you go about that. But for me, I think it's cute enough to the other where I can go about it with my weird team of character. Anyway, so I read on there enough. What about writing? Well, it took a tough way at work. It's entertaining. We really get entertained by you. Quite a bit. I mean, each movie, we probably play plenty of fun because I like the character and the team that. And they do a good joke with the concept of pointing out a human doing this more human like thing. And then the movie, they get to hear that, even though narratively the character gets. They each get a good moment. Glorioka and her brother, I think they're entertaining and funny characters to watch, and they're really interesting as well. Character. I mean, think about it, well, I can't help but get from Meyer fighting again here because she played for humor way more than the other movie, and Ricky did a joke that this game could might be a joke from SpongeBob Water, and you probably know which joke I'm referring to, and it's pretty damn funny. It got the biggest laugh out of me of all the stuff here, but at the same time, I do feel like, and to be fair, she wasn't all goofy and weird, I mean, but this one, all the other movies, definitely get put up a little bit here in terms of. That happens, but I don't think it's too big a problem because it's not actually pretty good, and it's not like an hour thinking, no care. So, I tell you about what? Okay, in terms of writing, I think we'll come genuine moments that come even placement, I think, haggard moments, you know, and putting climax, yeah, you know, go, wait, and gonna get back, and like I'm trying to say, but enough, you know, would barely make up for the thing, okay, we're going really. There are enough moments that work, that counteract moments that don't work. Game moments that don't work can work on their own. I think the problem with the part of React, they don't get any deeper than before. If you're going to use an element you perform in the franchise, you have to add something to it, and here they just don't technically. But I feel like if you're just judging how you're not going, then it's fine. But at the same time, I always say that comparing is pretty good at taking an element done before and adding to it. Sometimes they are doing well, but you believe it's good at that. And then they're trying to be a hit or miss with that. And here, but yeah, we're doing. But the one, the big thing I'm going to regarding the villain, and this franchise had a spotty entry of the villain. In the first movie, you were going to outfit a film about. Not particularly threatening or interesting for that matter. It took until a second movie about to happen. And also a prequel comic I forgot to mention. got it. That become pretty interesting. I feel like that make. I feel like that movie had that super more rounded. And for me, we had this dude, Prinkable Perkin, who made dumb decisions. Yeah, probably the favorite film in the franchise about Church of Magic for that reason. She's not interesting. Great role from though. And go, you've had the dangling arm related there. You know, depending on that, if you're threatening or entertaining or good villain, they work well. So this movie going to figure 8, we're just going to drop that and just have the, more internal, or they're going to go have another generic role who might be a little better. Instead, they have a good villain. Now, I'm not going to get into my favorite villain, hearing the franchise noise, but in order to have to move with it, but I genuinely like the villain because of what they do with it in terms of narrative. I already had to pause again, get my dog to keep capping. I like the pro guy who told him down here. She keep barking again. She barked more time long with him for that guy told him down here. Anyway, what makes the villain better is that it kind of gets in character to have to be a villain, which they work into bigger narrative. And I hope I'm interrupting them. To be fair, I keep on, it's not like you're gonna hear me jump cut a few times, so it's not like a that big of a deal, but I'm gonna keep starting my thing again, which gets annoying, but hopefully I can wrap it up. Okay, they start with that again. Instead of having a villain who literally comes in and doesn't get to be the villain, even that would kind of technically on that, the type of villain who hide the villain. But here, they come crime mystery of who that is, and then that real and that becomes something. Never leave. And I think here at one point, the villain actually has a motivation for action, and you kind of feel fine for them because you see what we're doing, you know? And what we do, and even though we're forgiven, what we do, it kind of works on the Twilight Night stuff, which they don't connect as much. You think with Twilight Night stuff, she would. They hint at it a little bit, but Twilight doesn't confront her, they don't have a big moment over that. With how much Welcome Midnight, you think they will connect to the thing a little more. But it's more similar to that, where, Twilight, in general, they're going to get corrupted and blah blah blah, and that kind of thing. You can use the magic value you really get with. They connect to content, though. And here, it's more similar to that, where nobody has been put fine to begin with. And I feel like that's more interesting, and when you hear a backstory, after a backstory, I'm like, wow, I feel sorry for the villain. Up to when the franchise actually happened. We can't get your punk to in the first movie, but it doesn't work in the second movie. I've finished this morning, and again, that can be great, but they're more not proof to be some stronger good character and having going against some other good villain, Mako Dagar. And they're still better. The person becomes very more threatening, but she becomes villain, she becomes a good friend. She has cool powers. You can probably tell who it's going to be, but it doesn't count really. And I will think one thing take me for that her what happened after what kind of called for the client which happened to before the life about him, about credits is getting medic. And each one's been about that length for that credit before. Roughly something slightly shorter. I think we're all roughly getting medic overall. I looked at that on the bottom, but they count credit and I didn't check. I know this weekend they collect credit. But after she turned back to normal, Dick, like, oh, we're forgiven, let's move on. So we have to move on to another, like, element. The Kaga gave a tree type thing, but don't worry, it's more of a. It worked way better than they did in that one comic card review. Great stuff. I would say it was officially annoying, but it became officially annoying, like, an hour ago. And it's only 20 minutes long so far. Anyway, yeah, I got to get what. They kind of rush them, but my point I'm trying to make, that's the thing, going in tangent, I'd make a point, then I go on a tangent of a point, then I come back to a point final plan. The whole reason I bring that up is to bring the point that they do want to come out, and they're kind of like, okay, you're good now, let's move on to come out. Like, I feel like that takes away a little bit. I feel like if they put a little more effort on it at the end, it would really round it out, but I feel like some people will. Like, less of the villain stuff becomes me rushing at the end. But it's not that big of a deal, and it's overall my favorite narrative movie because it is the rich element and the newest element in terms of the writing. So, the fact that it got a villain I genuinely like, and even for some point, the character is so entertaining and having the element to them that makes it entertaining to watch. So, Kudo for a girl I like. I'd show people why you won't keep on your way, but, hey, I still might feel either way. So, Kudo, God, go definitely one thing over game, and, sorry for me, one thing after the game, you know, if that, it had a villain I actually like, you know. Maybe I'm more on top of that. Okay, let's start wrapping up. Okay, let's start wrapping up, because I forgot what I'm going on. I was about the villain and the rush and the story thing. So, overall, I would say I do like this entry. Yeah, I can have a lot of resettlement. The, I can have a lot of that rehash and don't feel quite strong. There are some else that could use work, and the songs aren't quite as memorable before, but at the same time, there are radio from January that sing with them. There are some elements that do genuinely work, like the villain, and there are some fun characters, and it's quite entertaining throughout. Even when it gets to that part, it's not annoying or boring. I mean, the first movie, I get so objectively, you make fun of it. At least be fun to make fun of how dumb and belong to say it. In each movie, I don't. And some people can kind of get into that, you know, which is why in that part, people actually enjoy making fun of. So, for the most part, we're all be mostly like, okay, even I can't perfectly comply, but the Queen family can entertain one. So, where I mean, I couldn't really. Before that, I would say the best from the first game of the first movie, because when it came to sort of narrow, we done very well in the first movie, but now I feel like we actually want to have. I can't bring out the reaction from the movie. First game, people seem to. When general PFK is pretty solid a lot to like it, I really rock. Well, a couple people like it, I don't like it much. A couple people might like it more, but more people at best like it, I don't like it much. And this movie might have similar reactions where people agree with that first movie, but some people don't like it, whether it's solid at all or whatever. I think people. It depends. I haven't read any, reaction yet for people who are. From that million herring, apparently some wait, not that long wait time for you. It's really got to jump kind of, but yeah, in hindsight, I probably should wait till I was done the next day and done this. But I already watched the movie, so I can't go back. I don't want to wait too long because I like the idea of being a first impression. So, for the kick, last half hour and month, the probably 10 to 12 minutes I took while being away from the computer to give you time to do it, it's still roughly first impression. But hey, bad Viago better than no Viago, so. Anyway, but overall, it's okay, I enjoy it. Garnico and PLK, I enjoyed it. One element that makes me bad go better for the game, but it's slightly weaker, primarily in scale of entertainment value of that one. It's not quite, the first one where I flip between stuff I could genuinely laugh at and stuff I laugh at because it's kind of dumb. This one I'm having my first game format is a genuine, it takes a lot more consistent. So, I did enjoy this one, but in terms of story, it's not the greatest written. And the songs aren't quite memorable before. Again, not that songs can probably always great, but I feel like they're general solid, especially where I'm going to go. But, well, there you go, very critical score. Where should it go from here? Once you get to my franchise, you can start repeating yourself. You should pack it in. I feel like every new fifth movie they have to become completely different. And what kind of cool way to think we have left to do? We've done all the major things at this point. So where can we go from here? I don't think I'm gonna have one next year because that's Gash movie and it's my clash of that. So more likely I'll be one next year, but and if they don't next year, it's gonna be over in 2018, so it could be the last one. So either A, they move on to a snow series, or A, just kind of pack it in, or they can cry me to some dumb little different to that than Derry and before. I understand why, that's why it gets all your development. You know, because we already can't develop too much because they'll feel, I don't know, feel weird to have, get away a flush. It would be kind of like, I don't know, it'd be a little awkward. It's not gonna, until I had different deals than they have in the Equestrian world, while with the main kick may deal with some stuff, but I don't know, I feel like being a Kill Rock felt cultural ensemble with each one a little something compared to for the game and this where better to kind of off the ride. But I feel like personally I would just end it here and do a spin-off show. I feel like you were a lot more team carrying being a look at start, each one that first really felt the most like a genuine movie. one from the 14 movie, the movie but 13. And this one from called from 19 movie but only 18. But I feel like this is coming, we could have done like an absolute apocalypse of French English, not to make it movie ish. But I feel like the movie elements are kind of hurting it because somewhat thing has been there because the movie, so we need to change the movie. And the French game is the villain that favorite part of that. This one is the only good part of that, go. Got it, kind of too. But in general, it's okay. I like this. But I will probably just get it after this because now we have so much more body in question. But now it is bothering me. Go. I feel like we can get to that point, we should stop. I know from Cash Cow franchise, but we have Flash movie coming out this year, so I feel like, you know. I think we should buy I don't want to continue on the show, or at least in the comics, I mean. Right. Hopefully I got some, because I am wrapping this up, especially now. 6.5 hours, time to begin, and then I'm going to go to the waiting room to go, but that's why I don't have to come now, so, yeah. Yeah, I'm talking about comic book. I couldn't comic come in a few so far. People comic and that winter holiday festival was somewhere again. There's still more of them. It's made to do a whole comic book for two. I feel like if they're gonna stop moving here, do bad if they don't want to go to Nashville, which was supposed to be it again with. But I don't know how. I'm trying to get it. It's not that they planned for the show beginning of the game movie. I mean, they can probably in their head, they went, we're gonna do a spin-off show that will be like a pilot. But so far we haven't gotten that, which maybe they didn't have the idea at all, but at this point it's starting to kind of feel like one anyway. So, either A, they do a spin-off show, it's not a big movie, or at least not doing it for a while until we have something shown about, or just not doing it, we go, you know, it's more of the comics and stuff like that. I don't know, yeah, going to put effort into it, I'm fine. If we have got good with it, and maybe the biggest thing today that the change, right? The first two Megan McCarthy and other people done this here is one, and these guys is the other. And then McCarthy writing, I think it's supposed to be well, she has writing part of that part for me, but most of the gag now, like, technically she's genuine, don't get in common. And it's sort of the gap, play, and so they have come to the show, and I feel like, dude, for me, McCarthy kept writing it probably, I think she needed writing it prevented that way from being more stagnating than it could have been, but I feel like, you know, bring her back now as we go. You think bringing her your time would prevent it, but I feel they should bring her back at this point. Well, she can wreck a role in the show lately, too. Go. Either way, we'll have to see what happens, but I still think it was a pretty entry, even though I do think objectively it's better for me, but not quite as complete in terms of narrative in the first game, but definitely not good for a lot, bro. I still think. I gave a color first we were decent where it's good, I go on fine. Where the with a lot of games being a good movie. Well, yeah, it's close to the movie. But I told it was all entertaining. And this movie I can go, well, I have fun with it, and I feel like from there I'm gonna work. Go, there, whatever for you. Worst feeling I've ever done because I kept in the game truck. At least I made a pause, so you only caught jump cut, but I kept going on my camera. There you go. I kind of showed you from Wiki. Oh well, here you are. I'm gonna like take my last joke. At first I thought I'd probably off, wouldn't mind waking people up, but there you are. Like, if I'm gonna wake people while I'm in my own house, I'm not gonna wake people up while I'm outside. So I should have done that. Because, you know. Yeah, no, can I would want to. But, go. You know, how will you? Again, I haven't seen too many reactions from the people caught. That other play, but you know, more people figure out. I think people in general, well, people who have been along with French Tiger, but like, you know, probably still get into another one. But I guarantee you, reaction will be very well for French game. Give me a. But yeah, five person is like, well, you know, yeah, it's not as good as a couple of the others. Hey, it's doing a thing, and it was fun to talk about this vlog because, you know. You know, again, the reason I didn't just wait after I could have, after I broke. I watched the movie, might as well do it, you know, but could have waited be on to it later, but, you know, at least next month we'll do tomorrow, and I won't, I forgot, my plan was to go to after I posted that, watch the episode of Quick Dogs for tomorrow's episode, and go, fuck, you won't even see this until, like, after that vlog posted, and on that vlog, we're talking about vlog, you won't even see it, so, yeah, God, if I put, well, people can't get it, but people will be up by now. I could fucking come right when I wake up before I start. Go, but okay, I'm gonna mention Everfree. They call it later episode next week. I don't know the episode. I'll talk about it in that vlog. Bye. So yeah.